Kim here with Little Biz Resources, and I had a question about how to publish from RSS to Pinterest. And that's because Pinterest actually has an RSS feature, but it doesn't seem to be working. So let me go over to Pinterest here, and I'm in the editing of the profile. And if you go to Bulk Create Pins, you have an option to connect an RSS feed to auto publish from this domain. You've connected your domain and everything. You've got to have that all connected already so that it's claimed as yours. And then you want to come in here, and I actually put in one from FeedBurner and then one directly from my site. Can't get either one to work correctly. I don't know why. In fact, I actually created some boards for it, and I think I might have finally deleted them because they never, this one's via Publer. Yeah, they never updated. So I ended up deleting them like a month after I added those because it wouldn't work. That might be e-commerce specific. You know, I haven't tested with a blog yet, so I'm going to test that with a blog another time. But for now, I can tell you that it's not working with my WordPress site, at least. Shopify might, I don't know. I'll be testing all of that. If it's not working for you, if you go through the settings and you're like, hey, I can't, you go into the edit profile, you go into Bulk Create Pins, you edit this and add it in, you can add another here. As long as they're yours, it should be fine. But again, mine's not working, so I can't tell you for sure if that's the way it works or not. I can just tell you how it says it's supposed to work. So if you have the problem I do, and I suspect this is e-commerce related, it's because it uses a different type of RSS feed, and I think they want to push you to the Pinterest Verified Merchant Program, which is mostly what we talk about. But if you're having trouble getting verified, how can you get your pins on there, right? Now, this doesn't mean that you're going to have rich pins, because rich pins have the requirements, which these are product pins, or rich pins. To the requirements to have those are pretty much the same as the Merchant Verified Program. Verified Merchant Program. I can never get that name right. So the only difference between it, as far as I can tell, is time frame. So you at like 7 or 8 months, you can get rich pins or product pins, whereas you have to have 13 months. Your domain name needs to be at least 13 months old to be on the Verified Merchant Program. So let's look at how to do RSS feeds, just in case this stuff breaks, right? So I'm in Publer. Publer is what I use. You can use whatever scheduling tool you want that uses RSS. I actually tried to look for a lot of them, but not many list RSS specifically. So if you use one, check to see if they can use RSS feeds. If not, I use Publer. There's a link in the description. Now, they've changed this up since the last time I've done videos, which was not that long ago. And they've moved RSS feeds to Explore. So when you go into Explore, there's trending post, news, and then RSS feeds. So you'll probably see this first, but we're going to go to RSS feeds. And I actually deleted the one so I can add it and show you. You're going to name it. I already have a bunch in here, but you're going to name your feed whatever you want. I'm going to put this one as Celtic Ornaments because that's the website. I'm going to paste in. This is the FeedBurner feed. I use that one just in case it's useful, but I don't know that there's any value to it anymore, but I have it, so I'm going to keep it. And then you hit add. Now, it says it's going to take a few seconds. This can take a little bit longer than a few seconds. I have done this in another video where I showed you how to connect the RSS feeds. This one's specifically for Pinterest because it's a little bit different and has a little bit of nuance to it because of the boards. And I actually had to go in and do some settings to make sure that my specific board that I wanted was selected, and that for the automatic ones. So I'm going to show you how to do that. A couple of things you should know about RSS feeds is that you have no control over it in this particular format. So we've done some other ones, like in another video I showed how to use Zapier, which we're going to do again, but I'm not going to do it with Pinterest because Pinterest is one of the paid platforms, and I am aware that it did go to the next step. But Zapier as the paid level, the reason why I don't want to do that is because there's mapping involved. And using something like Publer, you don't have to map, which mapping just means that you have to tell it where the title is, where the image is, and so you have to pull in all the information from your website feed to Pinterest feed, right? So Zapier is in the middle, and you have to tell it, okay, this information from this side goes to this information on this side. And that's more work than I want to do. So we may look at it eventually, and if that's something you're interested in, let me know and I'll explore it. But right now we're just going to use Publer because that's what I use all the time. So edit RSS feed is the next step. So after it's come in, now you can say no action, and you can just come in, you can pull it in here and say, why would I say no action, Kim? I'm pulling in, wouldn't I have an action? Not necessarily. And a question came up in our Facebook group about, if I have the verified merchant program and it's creating automatic pins, what happens to the variations? So if you have a product and that product has more than 11 images for variations or multiple pictures for whatever, if you have more than 11 pictures on a product, you will only get 11 pins created, and that they'll take the first 11, and the ones after that, it will not post. So the value to no action for our purposes could be that you decide to bring that in, you bring in the RSS feed, and then you go through and say, okay, I know that 12 through however many didn't publish, so I am now going to schedule those, or I'm now going to post those, right? Which I wouldn't post them all at once. I would schedule those out. So that is one way to do that. And I'm sure there's many other reasons that you may not want to take action immediately. In fact, you could just bring it in so that you can have them available, right? If you're like, hey, I don't want to schedule them because I already have them in the Pinterest Verified Merchant Program, but I want them available just in case I want to post them somewhere else. Because it's not just for Pinterest, right? You can go to Facebook. You can go to, I was going to say Twitter, X. You can go to X, which is so weird to me. That name is weird to me. It's hard for me. So Twitter/X, you could go to, Instagram, right? So there's some different things that you could do later on, or you could do immediately even. So you can take this RSS feed, bring it in, say no action, so you can do something with it later, or you can auto post it so that it automatically posts to, like, let's say that you update right now, right? So you publish something right now, a new product, it would then auto post probably within 24 hours. I say that because it really depends. Generally, it should be within about 15 minutes. But sometimes, especially depending on your website and the server that it's on, it can take longer to export that information. And then if the incoming servers are delayed, that can delay it there. If Publer servers are overwhelmed, which I haven't seen yet, but theoretically, if they have overwhelmed servers, it could delay there. I mean, so I would say within 24 hours, but generally it's 15 to 30 minutes. So auto post, you post on your website, then it auto posts to wherever you tell it to, and we're going to do Pinterest. Auto schedule is when you set up a schedule and it's just going to schedule it into the next spot or however you say. So we're going to say auto schedule because that's the most complicated one. So no action, obviously, no action. Auto post, automatically posts it. Those are easy. So let's look at auto schedule. Now, whether you're doing auto post or auto schedule, you need to select use the article title as caption or use the article description as caption. Okay, and that's up to you. You might want to just interchange these. So kind of looking behind here, this is the title right here, and they're saying use it as a caption. I don't know how that would work on that. Let's say, let's just come down here because that might be a little bit different. We're going to go into the Easton Twins. And this one says post new articles as links, or you can post them as photo. We're going to do links because that's where Pinterest is. I clicked off that so you can see that the Pinterest account is there. And we're going to say use the article. I mean, I have the title in the description, so why not use the description? And it'll just take how many ever first characters it needs. So now it says select label. This is, you can also, by the way, schedule this to multiple places. Let's say that I wanted to do to both of those. I don't know why that stays open. If I wanted to do to both of those, and then I could select a label for, because I'm scheduling this. Now this label is for, there's no label, so that wouldn't be the one I'm doing, right? So YouTube videos, it's not a YouTube video, it's my RSS feed. I pre-labeled that, and I put that into the schedule. I did that in another video. I'll link over to that video so you can see it. So I'm going to save this, and then I'm going to be done for right now. Now, what you didn't notice, I don't have a board that I selected, right? So I need to make sure that in my social accounts, I go into Pinterest, Easton Twins, and I look at my boards. So this is my Pinterest default board for the Easton Twins as Little Biz Resources updates. I'm gonna leave it because I actually have some other stuff going there. I can't change it. So I can only have one RSS feed coming in. You may just want to, if you have multiple RSS feeds going into the same Pinterest account, you might want to just make it a general board where it says awesome stuff or amazing things. Now, that doesn't give you any keyword optimization, but it helps you get the pins on there. And if they're product pins, which I don't know, because if you don't qualify for product pins, they're not yet. But if they are product pins, then you can tag them later and you can do more stuff. If they're not product pins, you can still do a lot with pins, right? And they're still going to be out there. And if you do the pins right, which is where RSS feeds are a little bit tough, because if you don't optimize it on your website, that optimization doesn't carry over, right? So if your title isn't optimized, your title and your description aren't going to be optimized in Pinterest either. So it's critical that you do this, see how it's out, see the outcome, and then make tweaks. Okay. So there is no perfect way to do this. You might find out that, hey, you know what? I don't want to, that here's another thing. If you wanted to go to a specific board, you might want to just not post, you know, not auto post it. So if you want to change it, by the way, you can go into RSS feeds. You can select the feed and go into Celtic ornaments. You can see it's pulled these in. So now I'm going to say settings, and I'm going to say next, because that's the second page, and I'm going to say no action, and I'm going to say save. Okay, so that's just how you would edit it. Now, there is a little bit of playing with this, right? Because, again, you want to, I have these Celtic ornament designs, digital, orange, gold, purple, set A, set A, set G, set F. That's not valuable, but it's as good as I could get it on my website and have different things on there instead. But I repeated it in the first sentence, which I don't necessarily need to do in the description. So I may want to instead redefine this. But I want to see how they come out on Pinterest side as well. Do you want to look at and see how is that translating and is that what you want, right? So that's how you can do it with Publer. Most of the other scheduling tools are going to be very similar to that, where you have the RSS feed come in, you give it a little bit of instructions, and then you either auto post it or you schedule it out, right? That's going to be generally the way it is with most of them. If you like Publer, I love Publer. I use it for all my scheduling stuff. So all my manually scheduled like this. So I use it for Pinterest, Google Business. You can see right here, social media, social accounts. I use it for Facebook. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Facebook pages right now that are active on it. 3 Instagram accounts, 2 Pinterest accounts, and then I have 2 Google business accounts right now. So in fact, I need to go into this one and post some stuff. So that's, Publer is really useful for that, and RSS feeds can be used all over the place. So if you have your website and you're like, hey, I need to do an RSS feed to go to Pinterest, do you need it to go elsewhere? You know, do you need to go to Facebook or Instagram, or if you have a Google business account there, do you need it to go, if you have images, it's probably not going to TikTok, maybe to Twitter or X in this case. And then there's more here as well. You know, we've got LinkedIn, you've got WordPress. You can go to another WordPress site or WordPress.com. So these are all the ones I have. I use RSS feeds to all of them. All of them. I use all of RSS feeds to every single one of them. So it's a very useful tool. I highly recommend it. I do recommend Publer, of course, but there are other ones out there. Hootsuite's kind of expensive, but they probably have an RSS option because they are so expensive. Buffer, I think I was trying to look at that one and I wasn't sure if they had our RSS option or not. But if you have any of those, check and see. You know, if you already have it, check and see if you can just implement that as well. And that's it for this one. Let me know if you have questions. Thanks.